are finally here back in Nepal and we are about to start our biggest, longest and most exciting trek that we have ever done.
We're here in Arigat and we're starting the Manaslu trek today. We'll be joining the Annapurna Circuit and eventually onto Upper Mustang, finishing in Jomsom and flying back to Pokhara after about 40 days. To Soti Kola, it's about 4 hours along from where we started today. It's a pretty easy hike, had some delicious dal bhat for lunch. I'm gonna go and get a shower, Kim's already having hers, and then we'll just rest and relax for the rest of the day.
Day two today, we're heading on to Mata Kola.
There goes the bus.
That should be about 5 hours?
Five hours.
Maximum 5 hours.
I like the sound of that.
Hiking from Mata Kola to Jagat today. It's about 16 kilometers. It should take us about 7 hours. It's the first day we'll be hiking on a trail instead of a road. So it should be more interesting and more fun.
Day four today, we are leaving Jagat and heading to Dang. Is that how you say it?
Dang.
Dang. Check this view behind us.
Yeah, it's not
who
bad.
Who doesn't like a window like this? We saw a wee monkey outside.
We saw a monkey this morning. Anyway, it's time to get back on the trail and head to Dang.
Yeah, long day ahead.
How is it?
It's rustic. That was a calf burner.
Day five on the trail. We're heading from Dang to Gap. It's been a lot of up and down so far today. Didn't take long to get a sweat on, but it's only about 4 to 5 hours at the very most today. So a bit of a short day compared to the last 2 days. Looking forward to getting there and having the rest of the day to relax, do some washing, drink some tea, all that sort of stuff. Day six already. We're on our way to Logon today. It's about 13 kilometers and we're going up about 900 meters.
Day 7 for us. We're heading up to Samangong today. We're going to spend a couple of nights up there because it's around 3,500 meters and we need to acclimatize before we head over the 5,100 meter pass or something.
5,002.
Is it?
Yeah, something like that.
Even higher than I thought. About 4 hours trekking today, maybe five with photo stops, who knows.
There's going to be some amazing views, so I think we're going to stop quite a lot.
P.S. I'm really sorry about my hair. I haven't had a shower for a few days. I know it's minging. I got trail dog back. Arrived at Samangong. This place is gorgeous. Absolutely love it. And we've arrived before lunch, which is very nice.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, we're having some dal bhat right
now. No surprises there.
Which is, yeah.
Twice a day, every day.
Lunch and dinner every day. See if we can keep it up for the whole time.
I love it. Good morning.
Morning.
Day 8 for us, and it's our rest day today here in Samangong. Except we're not having a rest. We're going for a little hike up to a monastery. So we go about 400 metres up.
Yeah, a bit of acclimatisation, and it's no big bags today.
Hopefully we can go to that coffee shop on the way back down as well.
I'm sure we can.
There's a coffee shop with real coffee. Oh, we've got some really good views of the mountains as well today. Yeah. Woke up with spectacularly crisp mountain views.
Crisp mountain views indeed. All right, let's go. Today we're heading from Samangong up to Samdo. It's just a short hike, maybe 3, maximum 4 hours. We're only going up 150 meters. Later today we'll probably do a wee acclimatization hike, maybe 100, 150 meters up, back down again, just to get used to the altitude. It was bitterly cold this morning, but sun's come out, things are warming up. Time to get the hat off.
Welcome to our room. I'll take this bed. We just arrived at Samdo. It only took us about 2 hours in the end. It's about 10:30,
getting a wee cup of masala tea. And we've just ordered some veg momos, mid-morning momos. It's kind of like a little treat, you know, a little altitude treat to get me going through the day. Momo time. Mmm. The outside has more of a steamed bun consistency than a dumpling consistency, and the inside is extremely tasty. Really good. These are veggie ones.
Camera.
Sorry.
She's too busy watching some eagles.
There's three massive eagles.
Yeah,
it's amazing.
They're great. We watched them yesterday.
Anyway.
It's day 10 today. We've made it up to Dharamsala, which is the last place we stay before we head over the Larke Pass. It's about 4,500 here, and tomorrow we go over a pass that's nearly 5,200.
It was about a 4-hour walk up here. We came up about maybe 500 meters. And I was feeling pretty shitty, to be honest, when we got up here. Got a real headache and started feeling pretty nauseous, and I was getting secretly worried that we were going to have to go back down.
But we didn't.
I ate some food and took some ibuprofen and drank lots more. Mm-hmm. And now I feel dandy. It's pretty basic up here. It makes our dungeon room from Dang look like a palace. It's kind of like staying in a Scottish bothy that's not been used in 20 years.
Anyway, we better go and get ready. So tomorrow, over the pass. What time are we going to set off tomorrow, Kim?
4 a.m. It is going to be Baltic.
Can't wait.
I think my head's going to be pumping. Woo! Wish us luck.
Pass yesterday. It was an absolutely cracking day, and really, really outstandingly beautiful up there. It did take us a total of 12 hours in the end, 8 hours walking. The reason was Kim got quite sick on the way up, not to do with altitude, but with
some lovely diarrhea, which happened in the dark and carried on the whole way up. Had to take some pills to try and stop it, and then I felt really nauseous at the top. Felt sicker and sicker, and then eventually projectile vomited on the way down.
Even when she was moving very slowly.
It was tough, but sickness aside, the pass was actually not that bad.
It's not too difficult, and it really, really is an amazing place to be. Oh. Anyway, today, what are we on to now? Day 12. We're going down to Dharapani. It's nearly 2,000 meters down from here, but it's quite a gentle descent, about 20 odd kilometers. So time's getting on, so we better get heading.
I have not washed my hands.
Steep climb.
This is meant to be a downhill day.
Good morning.
Good morning.
That's us come to the end of the first part of our trek, the Manaslu Circuit. We arrived here in Darapani at the end of a very, very long day as the rain was coming on, but it's been a really, really great journey.
For more detailed information about each day and things like how much stuff cost, where we stayed and who we trekked with, you can check it all out in our full blog post. It's in the description below.
Today we're about to start the second part of our trip, which is the Annapurna Circuit. Looking forward to seeing how things are different. We already noticed yesterday that the landscape changed quite a bit once we came down from the Larke Pass. So I think things are going to be quite different, much more busy.
Possibly a lot more road walking.
Yes, which we're not super excited about, but we'll see how it goes. Yeah.
Keep watching for part two. Mm-hmm. And if you've enjoyed this video, don't forget to give us a like. You can leave us a comment below if you've got any questions. And please subscribe to see more videos.
Of course.
And don't forget the bell.
Don't forget the bell.
You've got to get those notifications.
See you in part two.
Bye.
Bye.